difference is there. We Indians don't care about our things. Okay. We don't care about our monuments. You go to Taj Mahal or you go to Lal Killa or somewhere like Purana Killa and all, what you find there, that people, they go on writing on stones and everywhere, okay, and just destroying the beauty of that architecture. And due to pollution, so much of pollution is being created that the white marble of Taj Mahal, it's getting dull. Okay, so why all these? We Indians, we don't, we have got such a huge and a beautiful and a massive architecture of us. हमारे पास इतना पुराना धरोहर है हमारा साहित्य इतिहास का, इतने सारे मॉन्यूमेंट्स का, कि हम उसको प्रोटेक्ट नहीं करते. और ये फॉरेनर जो बाहर से आया है वो उस आर्किटेक्चर, उस ब्यूटी को प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए बिल्कुल तैयार है. और देखो, हमने उस हॉर्स को, जिसका इतना मैग्निफिसेंट हिस्ट्री, इतना खूबसूरत है देखने में, उसको कहाँ रख रखा है? उस पूरे गांव के सबसे एंड प्लेस पे, उस विलेज के सबसे एंड प्लेस पे. और उस किसी विलेजर का उस पर ध्यान नहीं है. नो वन इज बॉदर्ड. इवन मुन्नी, जो हर दिन बैठता आया है, उसके पास भी टाइम नहीं है कि वो गर्दन ऊंची करके उस हॉर्स के स्प्लेंडर को, प्राइड को देख सके. एंड हु came to understand the beauty of that architecture? This foreigner. ठीक है, how we are neglecting our property, our assets, our architecture, and how these foreigners, they appreciate them. Okay. Muni continued his description of the end of the world. And Muni, he was just continuing the whole description of his story. Our Pandit discoursed at the temple once how the oceans are going to close over the earth in a huge wave and swallow us. This horse will grow bigger and the biggest wave and carry on its back only the good people. He said reflectively, do you know when it is going to happen? He asked. Now, he says that the Pandit in our village, he said that that ki pure earth pe there will be huge waves, oceans, wo sare puri dharti ko apne andar wo samudra apne kar lega, ocean will, and this horse will grow bigger and it will carry only good people from here, and they, he will save only good people from drowning. And he say, Munni asks a question that do you know that when that time will come? The foreigner now understood by the tone of the other that the question was being asked and said, how am I transporting it? Now see, how, what a difference. Munni is talking about how only good people will be transported by this horse to other place and will be saved. Okay, this man catches this word transportation, and he speaks his own thought that that this man is asking that how he will transport this horse. I can push the seat back and make room in the rear, waving precisely at the back of the seat. He says that I will push the seats and I'll make space in the back side of the car. Tell me, will you accept 100 rupees or not for the horse? I'd love to take the whiskered soldier also, but I have no space for him this year. Okay, fine. So this man, he says that, Munni, that I'll give you 100 rupees. Tell me, will you take this 100 rupees and give me this horse? And he talks about that warrior. He says that now I don't have any space in my car, so I won't be able to take it. When we played Ramayan, they dressed me as Sita, added Munni. Now Munni started another conversation. I have my station wagon, as you see. I can push the seat back and take the horse in if you will just lend me a hand with it. Now this man is speaking something else. He's saying that I will show you how I will keep this horse at the back of my seat if you will help me. Do you know Mahabharat? Krishna was the 8th avatar of Vishnu. Now this Munni, he is speaking of Ramayana and Mahabharat. I really wonder what you are saying, because your answer is crucial. We have come to the point when we should be ready to talk business. Now this man, he is thinking all about business, that what will be the negotiation, kya baat hogi, kya paise pe wo log tikenge ki horse usko mile. When the 10th avatar comes, do you know where you and I will be? Asked the old man. Now this man, he is talking about mythology. He is saying that, do you know when the 10th avatar will come and where we both will be? Lend me a hand and I can lift off the horse from its pedestal after picking out the cement at the joints. Now this man, he is talking about that. He asks that, just lend me a hand. I'll remove the cement from the legs or the pedestal of this horse and I'll take it. The old man chattered away in a spirit of balancing of the credits and debits of conversational exchange, and said in order to be on the credit side. Now this old man, he was just chattering to make a balance. Here this man, he was crediting, okay, he was talking about what to come, and debiting what goes out, what debit was, what was coming in, okay, what was going to happen, and credit he was taking, he was all planning to take things out. And he just giving out sides in the conversation, he just took the credit side, that what was going out. Oh honorable one, I hope God has blessed you with numerous progeny. Numerous progeny means too much of children. You seem to be a good man, willing to stay beside an old man and talk to him. And he is very thankful to this old foreigner that this man, no one is having time to talk to this old Munni. Only this man is having, he's so nice that he is having time for Munni and he's speaking to him. But initially, since there is a language barrier between Munni and this foreigner, Munni is not able to understand why this old man is standing beside him and wasting his time. This foreigner, he is there for business, and Munni is not able to understand. Why he is not able to understand? Just because of the communication problem, language barrier. Okay. While all day I have none to talk to, Munni says that I don't have anyone to talk to me. Nothing the other interest in the speech, Munni felt encouraged to ask, how many children have you? Now Munni, very simple person, he just asked to him that how many children do you have, with appropriate gestures with his hands, realizing that the question was being asked. The red man replied, I said 101, which encouraged Munni to go into details. How many of your children are boys and how many girls? Where are they? This man is talking about money and he is talking about children. See, this is the difference between these two cultures. कल्चर के बीच का डिफरेंस भी देखो, एक इंडियन कल्चर है और एक वेस्टर्न कल्चर है. वेस्टर्न कल्चर कितना अपने आप में एडवांस्ड है, कितना मनी माइंडेड है, और कितना टू द पॉइंट प्रोफेशनली दे आर टॉकिंग एंड स्पीकिंग अबाउट थिंग्स. देर इज नो इंटरेस्ट इन ह्यूमन बींग्स, ओके. एंड यहाँ पे मुन्नी, ओल्ड मैन, इलिटरेट, नथिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, बट he is talking about everything which is related to life. How much he is concerned about this man's family, how he is talking. There is a bit of homeliness. Kuch baat hai ki kis tarah se hum utne materialistic nahi hai jitna west hai. Okay. तो अब वो पूछता है कि कितने बच्चे हैं तुम्हारे, कितने लड़के और लड़कियां, एंड वेयर आर दे. इन आंसर टू दीज क्वेश्चंस द रेड मैन डैश्ड हिज हैंड्स इनटू हिज पॉकेट एंड ब्रॉट फोर्थ हिज वॉलेट. ही फ्लरिश्ड द 100 रुपी करेंसी नोट एंड सेड, वेल दिस इज व्हाट आई मेंट. अब वो क्वेश्चन सुन के वो समझा तो नहीं. अब ये फॉरनर क्या करता है, अपने पॉकेट में हाथ डालता है, वॉलेट निकालता है और उसको 100 रुपीज निकाल के कहता है कि देखो मैं इस चीज के बारे में बात कर रहा हूं. The old man now realized that some financial element was entering their talk. अब पैसा देख करके मुन्नी realized कि कोई financial कुछ element घुसा है हमारे बात में. कोई crime की बात नहीं हो रही थी, कोई रामायण महाभारत और कल्कि अवतार की बात नहीं हो रही थी. बात क्या हो रही थी? Finance की, पैसे की बात हो रही. He peered closely at the currency note, the like of which he had never seen in his life. और मुन्नी ने 100 रुपए का नोट अपनी लाइफ में कभी नहीं देखा. Bichara poor person. What was this man flourishing a note for? Perhaps asking for a change. Ab Munni sochta hai ki bhai aadmi ye paise kyu flourish kar raha hai, samne dikha raha hai, ho sakta hai isko kuch